Ah, I love Hoenn music. Anyways, hello everyone, Godablaze here, and welcome back to my Chikorita family run-through of Pokemon HeartGold version. And by run-through, I mean boss run. Anyways, today we are going to be fighting Silver inside of Mount Moon, because, well, we haven't seen him for a while and he feels like fighting us. So yes, let's begin the battle. His six Pokemon against my one. Who will win? Well, it should kind of be obvious. Anyways, he leads in with Sneasel like he always does since he first got the thing, and just like usual, I go and one-hit KO with an Ion Tail, so yeah, nothing big there. And critical hit doesn't really help any, and yeah, Sneasel's down already, like the past two times, and he proceeds to send out Golbat, and despite the fact that they can actually survive a hit, unlike Sneasel, it's not a really big threat, because, I mean, sure, it has a double resistance to grass, it consists of two types that are super effective against grass, but seriously, look, it's using moves like El Cuddle. Okay, I've trained a Crobat before. I know the special attack sucks. And, yeah, so, anyways, yeah, Golbat goes down in two turns, because it didn't use moves like Confuse Ray or anything, and with the leftovers, I'm pretty much back to full HP, so yeah. Huh, this is the first time you actually get to see the leftovers. So, there you go. Anyways, so Silver goes and proceeds to send out Typhlosion, which actually poses a challenge. I go and use Toxic on it, because, well, pretty much poison this thing every single time we fight it, so I figured, might as well just poison it again. Anyways, I do take a Flamethrower, and it almost annihilates Meganium, like, just 3/4 of my HP, and burn. So yeah, that is really bad. I was like, it's like a forest fire there, almost. Except, the forest fire was isolated to one grass dinosaur. Yeah. Forget that, okay? So anyways, yeah, while I'm using the forest store, Typhlosion's just suffering from poison, which, thankfully, unlike Poison Powder and like the Burn Tower, where it took forever to take down for lava, Toxic, of course, as you know, doubles in damage, so yeah, it goes down faster, thank goodness, but still, all that damage from Flamethrower just hurts. And Typhlosion doesn't even have the Blaze ability activated yet. Hate to see how much it would do with the Blaze ability. Anyways, Meganium does use Body Slam and pretty much does end up activating the Blaze ability here, so what am I saying? Here we go, here's the Blaze ability, and look how much it does. It nearly takes out Meganium again. So, yeah. Of course, the Typhlosion here is, oh, like level 50, so yeah. It kind of ties with the highest level Pokemon we faced higher level Pokemon than 50, haven't we? I can't remember, I have to go and check. So anyways, sadly, even with the Body Slam, Typhlosion's poison damage wasn't enough to take it out, so I'm kind of having to go and use a Hyper Potion, bring Meganium's HP back up to 4, and just let the poison damage KO Typhlosion. So, while Toxic wasn't very helpful in the beginning, since it let me get hit by that really powerful Flamethrower, it did help out in the end with the poison damage KOing Typhlosion. So that always works. Goodbye, Typhlosion. We shall fight you another day. But tomorrow is not that day. So anyways, Silver here proceeds to go and show that he found someone to trade with. So yeah, here's Alakazam. And just like the last time I fought it as a Kadabra, I basically one-hit KO it with the power of Jasmine because its defense is pathetic. So yeah. Once again, just like Sneasel, it never got to show off any of its moves. And now after this, a rival reveals that he found a second person to trade with. Either that, or he just traded with the same person twice. Now, Gengar has actually managed to go up in difficulty here. I mean, sure, it is immune or resistant to most of my attacks, and knows a move Confused Ray, but it also now has the move Curse. And guess what move it's going to use? Curse. Of course, my Ion Tail missing doesn't really help any, but yeah, having a curse laid upon the only Pokemon you use for fighting, it's not a good thing. Seriously, a quarter of my HP gone at the end of every single turn? Not good at all, not good at all. So basically, I change my strategy. Instead of trying to use Ion Tail, I go for Giga Drain, since I'm like, if I'm losing HP at the end of every turn, I might as well just go and use a move that goes and restores some of it, at least. However, Gengar lives and decides to use the move Mean Look, because it's like, oh no, my only Pokemon I use for fighting is trapped in the battle. Whatever will I do? So yeah, Meganium continues suffering from the course, and I decide, even though it's at 1 HP, basically just use another Giga Drain, because, well, it's more accurate than Ion Tail. So, yeah. Gengar is down, and that leaves Silver with just one Pokemon left. Of course, I'm still cursed, but yeah. Anyways, that last Pokemon here is his Magneton, and wait, his last Pokemon's Magneton? Wait. Can I see some clips from the last few battles with Silver? Like, Bone Tower here? Okay, what about the Goldenrod Underground? Victory Road? What about Victory Road? Just as I expected, just as I thought I remembered. Why? Why is Magneton always the last Pokemon? Why? Silver, Magneton actually poses the most threat after Typhlosion. It resists all my moves. It is immune to poisoning. It can confuse me. It can paralyze me. I mean, sure, it can't really do much beyond that, but it's a really good inhibitor. It would do battle earlier in the fight. Because then, like, if you did that and confused me and paralyzed me, and then sent out Typhlosion after that or something, it would make a lot more sense, because I'm paralyzed and confused, and you're now sending out a Fire-type to annihilate me. Instead of setting feed this Pokemon for last, and then I'm like, I'm paralyzed, confused, and I'm being hit with a not very effective discharge. But, oh, well, too late. Power of Erica, you're down. Sorry. So yeah, hopefully he'll learn next time we fight him. Not to say that the Pokemon that's gonna stalling Meganium out for last, but we'll see. We'll just have to wait and see. So yes, we've beat Silver once more. Still haven't lost to him, which is a good thing. He seems to be improving some. Oh no. Come on, Silver. You need to complete that bond with your Pokemon, then they'll stop being so weak. But I'll still be able to completely destroy you. Anyways, we'll go take Meganium to the Pokemon Center that's just outside of this cave, and then just move on to the next boss, so yeah. Anyways, this is Gardevoir, and I will see you next time.